In this question, we have to find dy dx. So you'll notice that the y is inside this hyperbolic sine function. So to find dy dx, what we'll do is we'll just take the derivative of both sides with respect to x. So to indicate that, I'm going to write a ddx here on the left-hand side. So ddx of the left-hand side, so sinh y, should be equal to the derivative with respect to x, so ddx of the right-hand side. So ddx means take the derivative of whatever's inside the parentheses. So by writing this, we're just indicating that we're going to take the derivative. In fact, you can actually skip this step and then just jump straight to the derivative. Okay, so what is the derivative of sinh? Well, the derivative of sinh x with respect to x is just cosinh x. Now here, it's not sinh x, it's sinh y. So it'll be cosinh y times the derivative of the inside, which is just dy dx, right? It's not x, it's y. So when you take the derivative of the inside, you get dy dx. If it's cosinh x, then you would just get dx dx, which is 1, so you don't have to write it. And then here, the derivative of secant is secant x tangent x, the derivative of the secant function. We're almost done. We just have to solve for dy dx. So we can do that simply by dividing both sides by the cosinh of y. So divide here by the cosinh of y, and then divide this by the cosinh of y. So we get dy dx is equal to, and we're left with secant x tangent x, and all of this is being divided by the cosinh of y, and that would be the final answer. I hope this video has been helpful to someone out there in the world. Good luck.